It reminds you of home. Well, you spent that day time about 1.5 hours.
Oh, bullshit.
So there she is. She is airborne. She is still flying with us, which is an absolutely wonderful thing. And she brings enormous joy to thousands and thousands of people. She's flown for us today by Phil O'Dell, captain in the left-hand seat, and alongside of the right-hand seat is co-captain Martin Wood.
Oh no, he's changed his display.
He's got
the eight. That's on iPhone. But the bomb bay, when they open that, that's quite an impressive size. Don't know, they have to check the parachute from top to bottom, and the easiest and cheapest way of unpacking is to stream it.
To the Sky Club, which is the great supporters club, the biggest supporters club in the world, we think, for an aircraft, have their names on the inside of the bomb bay there. And I think you probably could get that done for yourself, but more about that later. As we see, I suspect, the bomb bay closing. That'll be the work of Phil Davis, the air electronics officer, closing those doors. And then looking through the little periscope he has on his desk to make sure that all is closed up underneath the aircraft. She first went into service as a nuclear bomber. She was part of the Royal Air Force's nuclear deterrent. We have a piece of paper drawn in 1946 by the great Roy Chadwick, who designed this aircraft, which is recognisably this aircraft. That's only 5 years after the Lancaster flew. He also designed that. But if you stretch it a bit, you get recognisably Concorde. That's how far-seeing he was. See, she can tiptoe round when she wants to. She's about the size of a, not as big as you might think, about the size of an Airbus A318, a smallish airliner, almost exactly. If you swap the wingspan and length measurements around, you get the same figures. And you can see, trailing behind her, the unburnt fuel, which it tends not to get used with fairly low power settings, but as soon as Martin opens the throttles again, you see that disappear. She carries the Lincoln coat of arms on the fin, because of course Lincolnshire Bomber Rally for the Royal Air Force, plus the Panther's head crest of number one group of Bomber Command on the nose. That represents all the Vulcan squadrons in the 1970s. And as I said, the spirit of Great Britain painted on her nose, encapsulating everything she stands for. Because it has been an enormous roller coaster ride, this. She lurches from one financial crisis to another. We'll talk about money in a moment.